So I stand before you a little shaky but very proud. Before I started writing this speech, I asked Paul if there was anything I shouldn't say. He said no. So Caroline, this is his fault. I would like to say start by saying how fantastic Caroline's looked today. Yay! Every bit the beautiful bride. As for Paul, well, as our mum always said, if you don't have anything nice to say, don't say anything. You should just keep it. Okay. I know Paul tries hard, so what we see today is Paul trying hard. Right. All the books say at this stage I should introduce myself, but I think you know who I am.
Woo!
My name is Justin. I am Paul's best brother. Sorry, best man. I've known Paul since he came into the family when he was very small. In fact, he was a baby. I am his fourth oldest brother. The most handsome, most charming, I'm the fourth oldest brother, and I am truly honoured to be here today to sing speak Paul's praises. I would like to take time to mention my eldest sister, our eldest sister, Florence, and her... And her husband, Kevin. They have been the hub of our family, who have orbited around them since the passing of our mother. I think I can speak for each one of us, all three girls and five boys. We have all been guided, advised, and helped by them at certain points in our lives. They're very important. Let's count.
Class Florence, yeah.
Okay. Boys now. Okay. Paul was always a good boy, our baby brother. However, he did have his moments. When he broke both his arms and needed stitches above his eye, he fibbed to our mum that he did it at the park. In fact, he did it trespassing on the railway property on a Tarzan swing over the River Cole at the aqueduct. He was punished, though, by our mum, as she had to take him to the toilet as a 14-year-old. I went travelling after our mother passed away, and Paul ended up joining me in Greece before travelling on to Egypt, Israel and India. Paul came home for a family wedding and was considerably transformed. He had shaved his head, had fine pigtails at the back, was bronze and wore an earring, and he was also stick thin. Our sister, Mary, walked past without recognising him. Actually, I'm sure his travelling companion and friend, Pete Coach, will tell a few more tales. Isn't that right, Pete? Paul served his apprenticeship as a cabinet maker when he left school. Over the years, he has developed into an experienced and talented maker of bespoke furniture. Running his own business and building up a loyal customer base that values his services. He is a perfectionist in his work, and he takes pride in getting things right. Paul is a loyal friend and brother. But as an example of his friendship, when he took a part of Dennis Meehan's ear to the hospital so that it could be reunited with him. And after our mother passed away, Paul kept the house going, so while I wandered around Europe, he gave me somewhere to come home to when I did, on occasion. Paul went through a really tough time some years ago, and his daughters, Kitty and Mary, the beautiful two beside me here,
hey.
And later, Caroline, Max and Ruby, they've all helped to move Paul forward. And it is wonderful to see them all here together on this lovely occasion.
Yay!
And it's also great to see all the friends and family coming together on this day to support them in their celebration. We are all very proud of our baby brother and his accomplishments in life. I think today counts as one of Paul's biggest achievements today, namely committing his life to a wonderful woman like Caroline, and in doing so devoting all of the friendship and love within him to another person who's his best friend and now his wife. We have been privileged to witness the promises that they will share their lives by giving each other their love, care, and consideration. We wish these two the happiness together.
Yay!
In my experience, finding love and friendship and a wonderful person, or woman even, only enhances our lives. Before we toast the happy couple, I would like to read a couple of passages from a book my daughter Star bought for this occasion. It's called Don't, or Husband. Published in 1913, it still seems very relevant today in today's world. So I thought I'd share you a few tips for a happy and fruitful marriage. Don't nag your wife. If she's burnt the cake or forgotten to sew on a button, she doesn't need to be told no over again. Don't scowl or look severe. Cultivate a pleasant expression. even if nature hasn't blessed you with one. Don't spend night after night at the club, leaving your wife alone to count the hours until you return. Wise words, I'm sure you will agree. Now, let's toast. Be upstanding, raise your glasses to this wonderful couple, to Paul and Caroline.
Paul and Caroline! Hey! There you go, you've got no light.